In this example, I'm going to look at a case where we start with liquid water in a container, and we put a vacuum pump on this container and pump very fast. So we remove the vapor, and then to reestablish equilibrium, liquid evaporates, and the energy to evaporate the liquid, namely that heat of vaporization that is needed, comes from cooling down the liquid. And we can do this in the lab sufficiently fast that we can freeze the liquid. And so the problem here is to start out with liquid at 40 degrees C, and we'll assume the system is adiabatic because we're doing this evaporation fast. The question is, when all of the liquid remaining has frozen, what fraction of water has evaporated? So essentially, we're going to apply the first law of thermodynamics to this system. Now, it's an unsteady state system, meaning things are changing with time. And the fact that it's adiabatic means the heat transfer is assumed to be zero. And so if we write the first law as the change, in this case a derivative, of the total energy in the system, so I'll write that as a mass times the internal energy per kilogram, for example. How that changes with time? Well, it changes with time. In the general form, we add energy by flow. We have energy removed by flow, heat added, work. These terms are zero. This term is zero. The only term left is the energy being removed. So we're going to start with a basis of 1 kilogram of water. And we're going to use the term X to represent the fraction of that 1 kilogram that evaporates when the remaining material has frozen. And so this first law, I can rewrite it because we're dealing with a liquid. U is approximately equal to H. And this is because H is U plus PV. This term, which is the volume per kilogram, is a small number relative to the other term. Good substitution because it's a liquid. Because U is equal to H, the energy balance, derivative mass times enthalpy per kilogram, respect to time, where both mass and the enthalpy change. And this is equal to the mass flow rate out times the enthalpy of that vapor leaving the system. So I can move the derivative sign to the other side, and also keep in mind the negative sign that's from here. So negative sign. So once I do that rearrangement, I can integrate from 0 to time t, and from my initial condition to my final condition, the integral of this derivative is just mh, now evaluated to two limits. So the final mass times the enthalpy of the final, which is ice, minus the initial mass, which is, in our case, 1 kilogram, times the enthalpy initial, which is liquid water at 40 degrees C. Now here, to do the integration, we'd have to know how this rate's changing with time. So we're going to make an approximation. We're going to say the amount that we removed, we've called X, and we're going to say the average enthalpy leaving will be a reasonable approximation, which is water vapor, since it's from 40 degrees C to 0 degrees C, I'll take water vapor at 20 degrees C. Now remember, this value M is 1, and the final mass then is 1 minus X. So 1 minus X times the enthalpy of ice at 0 degrees C. And so here are the values that I'm going to use. That I need enthalpy of ice at 0 degrees C. I need the enthalpy of liquid at 40 degrees C, and the enthalpy of water vapor at 20 degrees C. I'll look these up in a steam table. So this value for ice, minus 334, that's the heat of fusion. So that's a the value of our final, where H equals 0 is liquid water at 0 degrees C. The initial was 1 kilogram at 40 degrees C. And then the vapor, so notice it takes a lot of energy to create a vapor, so we're only going to evaporate a small fraction before we've frozen the remainder. So I can rearrange this equation. And so I can solve for X. And so this says that 17% of the water evaporates by the time the rest freezes. Of course, now the evaporation would slow significantly because the vapor pressure of ice is lower than the vapor pressure of water. This, of course, is assuming that we do this fast enough. It's adiabatic, so it's clearly an approximation. And because of that, it's reasonable to make the approximation of this average enthalpy of the vapor leaving at 20 degrees C. We expect it. Only a fraction would evaporate, so checking the answer, this number also makes sense.